Hello and welcome to the South American segment of the Peabody Museum's Fiesta Latina survey of the national birds of Latin American countries. Let's maybe begin with this big bird here. This actually is an immature Andean condor, Condor andino. Huge bird, the size of the California condor, with a 3 meter wingspan. And this is a baby because it takes them 8 years to achieve their adulthood, and the specimens we have here are immature. This bird amazingly was selected as a national bird for four different countries in South America: Colombia, Ecuador, Bolivia, and Chile. And this is the bird that to everybody symbolizes the Andes, and it's a majestic glider and relies on carrion, so it spends most of the time searching for dead guanaco or some other llama, or they can sometimes descend to the coast, and in Chile are known to eat things like beached whales or birthing seals. And this bird can reach about 15 kilograms in body weight, and in this case, females are slightly smaller than males. We have here a very bizarre looking bird named Hoatzin. This is a national bird of Guyana, where it's called Kanji pheasant, because it looked to some early explorers like a chicken-like bird. But in fact, it's a bird with a distinct lineage of really not very clear relationships. There is not really anything close related to it surviving today. It's a South American bird that lives in swamps and along rivers, and has two bizarre properties, features. One is that the chicks, after they leave the nest, they can clamber around, and they have three fingers in their wings, and later these disappear. Okay, so here we have a Hoatzin adult, and in this case, the three fingers of the babies are no longer here. They get reabsorbed, and the wing bones fuse. And the other feature that Hoatzin is famous for is the fact that they eat leaves, and they have a foregut with microbes that help them digest the plants, the leaves, and they spend a lot of time digesting like cows. This is kind of an equivalent to what ruminants do. And now let's look at the national bird of Peru. This is the gallito de las rocas, or the cock of the rock. Here we have a male. This is a bird that is still pretty common in most of the Andean countries, not only Peru, in the cloud forests. And you can actually arrange a visit to one of the leks. These are the places where they display. You can see that this crest here is a kind of flattened on the sides, two layers of feathers folding over the bill. It's only found in males. Females are drabber brown. And the name Gallito de las Rocas maybe refers to the fact that they spent the nest in little caves and attached their mud nest to a rocky wall. So then let's look at the bird chosen by the country of Suriname. This is in English Great Kiskadee, but in most countries the bird gets the name onomatopoeic, related to its song. It's a type of tyrant flycatcher, and the song to the English speaker sounds like Kiskadee, but to a person in Suriname, it's Grikibi or Gritibi if you are a Dutch inhabitant of Suriname. They also occur in the United States in southernmost Texas, and they go all the way to northern Argentina. So it's a pretty widely distributed bird, but very charismatic, found in cities and can actually easily be seen throughout South America. So now let's look at the national bird of Brazil, Sabia laranjeira, as it's called in Portuguese, and in English, Rufous-bellied thrush or robin. Same as the North American robin. These are birds common throughout suburban, rural, different habitats that are altered by humans, and it's one of the most common birds in this lower southern cone of South America, in Uruguay, Paraguay, Argentina, and parts of southeastern Brazil. This bird maybe looks not the most colorful, but has a fantastic song, and this is same as with the Costa Rican equivalent was chosen for the song and for its commonness in human inhabited habitats. Then this colorful bird here is, to a North American bird watcher, it's an oriole, but this particular one is called Troupial, and in Venezuela, where it's a national bird, they call it Turpial venezolano or Guajiro, because it's found in regional Guajira, among others. It's also found in the adjacent Colombia, and it's one of the largest species of orioles. And it's a bizarre species in the reason for that is that it doesn't build a typical hanging hammock-type nest, but it actually usurps, takes over nests from other species. It has to be a covered nest, so it could be another oriole or cacique, or even could be a stick nest of some furnarid. Then let's look at the bird chosen by Paraguay as a national bird. This is actually, here's the right species, but I only have an immature male. So this one here, you can see that still has a lot of kind of greenish gray feathers, but already developing its bare throat. In English, it's called bare-throated bellbird. And this bird here I'm holding is a white bellbird, a related species, but you cannot just imagine that this one would look like this, pure white, and just have a brilliantly bluish green bare throat. And the name in Paraguay, where it's a national bird, it's called Guira Campana or Guira Pong. Pong is onomatopoeic. This is the bird is most famous for its loud song. It's one of the loudest bird vocalizations. And it does sound a bit like a pong or like an anvil hit with a hammer, very loud and usually from the forest canopy. Then let's look at the national bird of Uruguay, Tero Tero, or it's called Southern Lapwing in English. Has a very thin little crest, has very interestingly spurs in the wings. You can maybe just barely see a little orange spur. Let me see, oh, here we go. And these could be used in nest defense when they chase away a fox or, and the bird is very charismatic, loud, attacks an intruder to its territory, especially when the chicks or eggs are around. So in adjacent Brazil, it's also onomatopoeically called Quero Quero. So Tero Tero, Quero Quero. And the species now expands and goes pretty far north, reaching Central America. And it takes advantage actually from human disturbance and clearing of the forest. Now we're switching. Here's the last example. And this one is a national bird of Argentina. This brown bird is called either Hornero or Aloncito or Caserita. And the fame for this bird is their nest. So here, if you can maybe zoom in on this fortress of mud, these nests are part of the landscape, and a pair of these, in a sense that they are found on buildings, on telephone poles. It's really a common sight in Argentina, adjacent Brazil, Paraguay, Uruguay. The nest is made by two of these birds, by a pair, and they somebody calculated to use like 3,000 beakfuls of mud, and this is mud mixed with plant material, so it's like adobe, very durable. And only members of this one group of birds, genus Furnarius, build these big 5-kilogram type fortresses.